benefits of the club and how valuable it is, none of what I have done today is going to cost the homeowner anything outside of his normal club payments. So all of this is just included in the club. So it's one of those things where it's like, for $19.95 a month, I mean, it's pretty nice to just always have a technician on call that even on one of the hottest days of the year, they're going to come out and give you quotes, let you know how the unit's looking, replace all your filters for you.
Morning.
We'll be going up through here. Furnace is actually up there as well. Obviously, things like changing filters, checking temp drop in homes like this isn't something that a homeowner will usually want to do themselves, which is why maintenance plan is usually a good idea on these old Olathe homes.
Okay.
Kind of a general rule of thumb whenever we go up in an attic, there's always 3 points of contact. You always want to have a hand somewhere and both feet on the ground. As much as you can.
And even more luckily, we left a spare filter for them, so I won't have to come back up and down.
Cool.
Something I'm going to do real quick is get the AC running so that we can go ahead and just check temp drop. Right now, they're cooling their home at 68 degrees, which to me, as hot as it's been, tells me that this unit is at least cooling properly. We're still going to check refrigerant. We're still going to give them an idea of, hey, is this unit leaking? Is it, how fast is it leaking? Things like that, just because of the age of the unit. We want to be as careful as possible. We always like to catch a unit before it fails, obviously, so it's not as urgent and something that they have to make a snap decision on. That's one of the main benefits of the club, is we will catch these things ahead of time. Go ahead and head on back up there real quick.
So, what we're looking for when we check temp drop is a 20 degree difference between your returns and your supplies. Right now, that's about exactly what we have, just right under about like 19.67 with a 19-year-old air conditioner. That's gonna be good. We're still gonna check refrigerant because you can be low on refrigerant and still be cooling plenty well, and it could be hurting your unit. And that's why a lot of people don't realize until it's extremely, extremely low. Grab this. We're not doing a full maintenance today. He's already had that done, so we're just kind of checking a few things out that he wanted looked at. Kind of just an extended filter change. Grab my gauges real quick. Obviously, this is the 19-year-old unit we're looking at. With these kind of units, occasionally we can get a good 20, 25 years out of them, but they will take a lot more helping here at the end. We're gonna go ahead and get our gauges hooked up, let the unit run for a little while, let it get warmed up, and then we'll go ahead and change the filter while it's sitting here with the gauges on. Go around this way. With these type of filters that the homeowner has, basically an electric air filter where it's polarizing some of that dust in there. Fantastic. It's kind of the best of both worlds when it comes to airflow and filtration, but they are a little more complicated to change, and like he was saying in there, if you do it incorrectly, you can blow a fuse and be without AC for a few hours. Also, in these old houses, you have these fun little cellars. So first thing we always want to do when changing these filters, shut the unit off. That way we don't have electricity running to it. So you can see that is absolutely full of dust. This thing's doing its job. And then I'm also going to grab a quick rag to just kind of get some of that dust out of there before I put a new filter in.
Okay.
So I'm going to toss this and grab one off my truck.
A lot of times you can get a technician out who has seen your unit before, kind of knows, already knows the situation. You don't have to re-explain things.
I think that's really valuable.
And also, as close-knit of a company as we are, we all talk to each other. So it's one of those things where if I'm going out to a call I've never been before, I can always call Sean or Mike or Javier and say, hey, I'm headed out to this call you were at out at last month. Give me the lowdown on kind of what you were seeing. And that just makes things a lot more streamlined so that we can take care of people quickly and get them heating and cooling when it's this hot outside. As quickly as possible is usually what people would want. And then with these, it's not too difficult. Can go either way, this way or this way. All we have to make sure is that this hook is touching this strip of carbon, so it's actually doing what it's supposed to be doing. Go ahead and tuck it in, make sure our corners are in properly so I'm not mashing it in there. Pull these back. You just gotta be careful getting it in there so we're not ripping the netting of the cage or anything like that. Right in line with kind of just below what we should be seeing. It's one of those things where we know it has a very slight refrigerant leak, and it's not worth adjusting at this point on a 19-year-old unit, considering that refrigerant isn't made anymore. But as of right now, it's not something we're super concerned about, as this is about as good as this unit's gonna be. Go ahead and get everything packed up, let them know that we're doing okay. Unit's cooling today. Everything seems to be right in line with what we've been seeing before. So just communicating that to the homeowner that it's running fine for now on a 19-year-old unit. Really anything could break at any time. And we'll just do our best to keep it maintained at its maximum level that it is capable of at this point.